What's up, guys? Today we are going to talk about generators in Python. Generators are special type of functions which exhibit the concept of lazy evaluation. So to understand the concept of generators, we need to first understand the concept of lazy evaluation. Laziness, as you know, is the behavior or tendency of delaying a work until the time when it is absolutely necessary. A similar behavior is exhibited by generators in Python. Generators are functions which generate a sequence of values. But instead of generating all the values at once, each value is generated when it is needed. So the question arises, why do we even have this concept of lazy evaluation? And the answer lies in memory and CPU utilization. Today we are living in the era where we have to deal with millions of records of data. Let us say we are to generate millions of records of data. But if you generate them all at once, then two things will happen. First, there will be a surge in the CPU utilization because all of these large amount of values will be generated at once. So there will be a surge in the CPU utilization, which might affect the other running processes in the computer. And also, when all of these large number of values are generated, these values need to be stored in the memory. So this will also increase memory utilization. Instead of that, if you just generate one value when it is needed and process it and then generate the next value when it is needed, then we will not have to store all the number of values at once. So it will reduce the memory utilization. At the same time, it will also reduce the CPU utilization. At least it will distribute the CPU utilization to a greater span of time. So there will be no surge in CPU utilization. So that is the concept behind lazy evaluation. Now let us try to understand this concept with the help of an example. We will take the example of Fibonacci series. So the Fibonacci series is defined as a sequence of number in which the first number is 0, the second number is 1, and all the consecutive numbers are defined as the sum of two preceding numbers. So 0 plus 1, that will be 1, then 1 plus 1 will be 2, 1 plus 2 will be 3, then 5, and so on. So we are going to generate this sequence by creating a generator. So we define a function like we have seen earlier. A generator is nothing but a function. So we define a function fib. It receives a parameter n. So first two values are fixed values. So we define two variables, first and second, and assign them 0 and 1. We need to generate n values. So we run a loop in the range n. And just for the sake of understanding, I am printing here a message. So whenever this line or this for loop is executed, we will see a message. So if the value of I happens to be 0 or 1, that is the first two values, then we just return the value of I. Otherwise, we calculate the next value by using the sum of first and second value. And then we also update the first and second value to be used in the next iteration. Finally, we yield the new calculated value. So here you can see, instead of using the keyword return, we are using a keyword yield. And this is the keyword which actually makes it a generator instead of a regular function. So now let us try to see this function in action. So first let us run a loop. So here we can see that all the five values have been generated and we got the expected output. But this looks quite similar to how it would behave in the case of a list or a tuple. So here we cannot really see that the values have been generated at once or they have been generated in a lazy fashion. So to verify that, let us try to get the value returned by this function. So I'll create g is equal to 5. Now if I check, g is not a list nor it is a tuple, but it is a generator object. And so far we have not seen this message yet. So it means no values have been generated yet. Now let us call a function next on g. So it will try to get the next value from g. So as you can see, first value is generated. You see this message and one value is returned. Once again, we will call the next function. And as you can see, whenever we call the next function, one value is generated. So the entire loop is not executed at once. Only one value is generated and it is returned. So this exhibits the concept of lazy evaluation. So this is very useful in the scenarios where we need only one value at a time, but we need to generate a sequence of values. Now obviously there are times when we need all the values available at the same time. So that is not a good use case for generator, but there are many other cases where we can deal with only one value at a time and then we can generate the next value when it is needed. So that is where we can use generators. So I hope this has been informative for you. Thank you.